Hello and welcome to Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning and I'm in the Deschutes River Canyon in Oregon. Now the Deschutes River Canyon is a very popular corridor for recreation including boating and bicycling and hiking, and is also a fantastic place to view geology. Now all of the walls of the canyons are almost entirely made up of the Columbia River basalts, chiefly the Grande, Ronde basalts, which is the largest and most voluminous member of flood basalt of the Columbia River basalt flows. And as a result, and because of its many different separate flows within its single flow structure, you can see many incredible features. Where I'm at now is about 12 miles up the canyon from the Columbia River, and along that 12 miles you can see a lot of very different types of basalt flows. You can see old filled-in lava tubes that stretch from the dike swarm, which started out near the border with Oregon and Idaho, and stretch all the way out to sea, which causes some of the capes on the famous Oregon coast, including Cape Mears and Cape Lookout, which are all chiefly made of this Grande Ronde basalt flows. Also, you can see areas of these flows of basalt that have been moved through water, but not as pillow basalt as we see in underwater footage of lava flows in Hawaii, but as just a single large fractured mass of rock that, as it flowed through the water, fractured and was under low pressure, so it sometimes has vesicles in it, or gas bubbles. And it also has large areas of columnar jointing, and which ranges from very large columns, some of which are several feet wide, to smaller columns on the order of less than a foot wide. Now also present in the Deschutes River Canyon, mostly along the canyon bottom, is if you see this white hill behind me, that is flood deposits from the Missoula Floods, which was an enormous glacial outburst flood series that is that inundated this area upwards of 80 times in total, between 20 and 15,000 years ago. And it backed up into the Deschutes River Canyon and other river canyons along the Columbia River, and left behind these deposits of mud and sediment and foreign rocks which are not native to the area at all. Deposits from the Missoula Floods provide also very fertile soil, which covers the Willamette Valley in western Oregon, and also probably enriched the soil here at this old farmstead called Harris Ranch. Over here you can see this big palisade behind me, and this big palisade tells a very interesting story. That palisade was carved by the river flowing against it. That's on the outside of a very large turn in the Deschutes River here, and you can see all of the different flows. Each one of those is a different member of the Grande Ronde basalt, except for the very top of it, which is the Saddle Mountain basalt, which was another major member of the Columbia River flood basalts. About here in the palisade, the basalt changes texture quite dramatically. It goes from cliff-forming, columnar-jointed basalts to a less cliff-forming, much more finely angular and jointed, more like rocks, just a rock pile. And from that, it can possibly be inferred that this is a former channel of a Columbia River or other major river that the basalt flowed through, and because it was going through water but didn't form a pillow basalt texture, it could have formed a different texture of basalt, which would have resulted in its distinct appearance from the rest of the cliff. This has been Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning. Thank you for watching.